I want to do a quick review of the 4 anniversary unit that they released for 4th anniversary, so I won't go fully over the kit. Rather, I will just go over how strong they are so far and how they perform so far, and if it's like, which one is worth pulling for. So first is Pardis, and Pardis is, he hit very, very hard. Even when his strongest multi-hit is an 8 multi-hit, he still very easily hit the damage cap with it. That's not fully power creep, kinda. So even though like Pardis exists and there's like the Pardis and Tadlock EX combo, both can still like coexist, right? Because both can still absolutely obliterate an enemy. So you have an option to choose between Pardis and Pardis EX. Wait, no, what did I say? Pardis EX, Pardis and Kaina. Overall, I think if an enemy switch to Dagger, then you still use Kaina. But if the enemy switch to one of Pardis' weakness, which is sword, fire, lightning, or dark, then use Pardis. So now you just have more option to obliterate the enemy with. Seraphina inflict like a effect on the enemy that counts as all status ailment. She does like many stuff, but essentially the one thing that most will use her for is that a passive where if a skill you use that is inflicting an ailment or is getting stronger because of an ailment, then that skill will hit any weakness. So, but like as of right now, there's not that many way to fully use that effect right now. Like yes, there are some units that can benefit off of this, like Jayne, but damage wise, Seraphina isn't like doing or supporting as much damage as some other character like Pardis is. As for Seraphina herself, she can be a decent dark DPS with a lot of debuff, but other than that, I think like there's currently no one that can fully capitalize off of Seraphina effect yet. Like I noticed this uni with like her newly buffed skill, so like all of her skill can now hit the enemy, but you would just rather use someone like Pardis if you have Pardis and just like obliterate the enemy with it. So Phantom Thief Erica or Kaito Eru. How Kaito L work is that whenever she's in the back line, someone does something, or someone attack in the front line, she will do a one-hit follow attack that is a shield shave. Now there's a difference of the follow-up attack between the one that Kaito L use and the one that most of the follow-up attack use. Is that Phantom Deep L use her own stat to do the damage, while most of the other follow-up attack like casting Heal Drop use the one that is doing the follow-up attack. Which from my experience on using her, the damage would not be as high. Because like, it was someone like Casty, right? Then if someone get like massively buffed, then that follow-up attack from Casty will also get massively buffed too. But since most of the time, Arrow will be in the backline, so she won't get the buff to fully do a lot of damage with the follow-up attack. One thing that is nice though, is that of the new, how the new mechanic for the ultimate work, she has an ultimate that increase her potency by 150%, and because of the new ultimate, she can combo with someone in the front row, so she's not wasting an action of the someone in the front row. So if she has the ultimate on, then she can deal some very decent damage and can hit up to like 200k, 300k. But you also need damage cap up for that to put on her. So overall, just imagine it was like kind of late for JP, I guess. Overall, L is like a decent shield shaver that does not take up any one action, and also free damage, like not a lot of damage, but still free damage, so it's not bad. And last is the Dardana EX, and she's a hunter this time, and she is currently like the best bow DPS in JP right now. Like not on the same level of strong as Pardis and Kaina is, but still is the best bow DPS though. So how the Dardana EX work is that she has a lot of like buffing skill, like passive buffing, bow buffing, active buffing, and also means she has a way to inflict guaranteed crit debuff on the enemy, which is any attack that you do to the enemy will be considered a critical attack. She does have one interestingly new passive though, is that whenever the Dardana do 9 critical hit on the enemy, she get 9 points, and at 9 points, half of her magic stat will be added onto her physical stat. And from my experience of using this passive, assuming you got like a pet that has both attack and magic stat, and also like invest in torch point also, and also you have A1 because A1 gives extra stat because the magic stat actually matters to the attack stat now. The effect is almost the same as getting 70% potency up, and it's really strong because it's not potency up, it's just extra magic stat added onto a physical stat, which means that character like Ringu EX or Solon Ultimate can still work on the third Aina, and then you can use the ultimate on her and then she can do like a lot of damage. If I were to compare her damage, I would say her damage is close to someone like Asuka. So it is like a DPS like grouping. Then at the very top, there's Partisan Kaina, which just deal massive damage even if the enemy is not broken. And then on the tier below that, there's character like Magnolia, Asuka, and now the third Aina. So she's like one tier below like the ultimate DPS. And lastly, out of these four units, if I were to rank them on the priority for someone who want to start the game now, right? Since it's the 4th anniversary and can reroll a lot, and also there's a 100 free pull, if I were to rank them on priority on who to get first, then number one priority would be Partis, and number two would be the third Aina, number three would be Seraphina, number four is Erica. And 3 and 4 kind of swap around, you can like choose who you want, because Erica and Seraphina, like, it's depending on whether you want like a dark DPS that can inflict status effect, that can help out other ailment attacker, or someone who's shield shaving. But although if I were to be honest, these two are sharing a banner, the duo between El and the third Aina, and Partis and Seraphina. So it's worth it more to pull for Partis and Seraphina banner than pulling for the third Aina and Erica banner. Oh yeah, and also as a bonus, if you do like the other character, we also have the rest of the villain here with us, Asuka, Tatlock, and the Dream Master also. So you have like a lot of choice to choose for this anniversary. So right now would be the best time to start if you haven't played JP yet, because the reroll, you have like a lot of option of character to choose from, so